action goes away, I'm looking for this action to come back. So this is called cross reading. I'm cross reading. I'm not looking directly to him, but as soon as he does that, I know to look back here to see cross read to see if anything's coming back to me. That's why they have them in a 2-point stance, so that they can cross read. You understand? And I want you to know that already. So bam, I cross read to see. I don't cross read automatically. He tells me my first step. He's gonna tell me my second. If this happens, boom, boom, then obviously that's gonna show up in my vision at first. I'm looking here. You with me? So triangles are based on your alignment as a backer. You're reading certain keys at the line of scrimmage. That's going to tell you what your first step is, what your second step should be, instead of just your eyes popping back. Because the worst thing that you can do as a linebacker is try to find the ball too early. You find the ball too early, you see that happening, you start running, and you get smashed here. Right, because you pursue something, not really identifying what you're gonna have to work through. So, to my point, if I'm this guy right here, we're thinking, what kind of play might it be? So it may be an off tackle run weak, or maybe an off tackle. Off tackle run strong. That's it. Okay. What he actually does, you know, what the play is, I'm gonna know as soon as I see shoulders. Yep. It's weak. What I thought, right? So this is, we gotta make predictions based on personnel and formation. But my first step is gonna be on his first, not on his first step, but you know what I mean? It's gonna be based on what his shoulders do. My first step is when the ball moves. But where my first step goes is gonna be based on how those shoulders turn. So right now, he's got a tap right now. See? Boom, see, that's my triangle. I read that. Look at that line. That's the wall of the triangle. Of course it's coming to me. So I'm here, I should be here. I should be bam, boom. So you want to kick me out, fullback wanted to lead up, and they wanted to hit it here. But pretty good job of setting a point here. But as a coach, I'm looking at the hash mark. So the hash is right here. He was inside the hash. He's now outside the hash. I would love for him to have stayed on the hash. So wherever your line is, you know, on the field, hold it as hard as you can. Hold it. If that's the hash mark right here, then try to keep to it without losing contact. Instead of, you know, drifting away from it. And now you're not being that sound wall, setting that vertical filler at all. You're just a flexible wall, which makes the defense run. Instead of attack the line of scrimmage, make everybody just run lateral. They want everybody to come downhill. That's going to take a strong outside back to set the point and play with their hands. This is surfing. That's surfing, I'll tell you. See, you know, that's surfing. Squeeze, serve, but he can go now, because, and this is where you got to be careful about that quarterback turning his back to you like that. Because he can show it, if he wants to show it, he can pull it. That's why he has to stay square. If this was the field right here, I'd be like he's doing, you gotta definitely check for this. Like I said, those shoulders told him right away. To be released, he replace him right away. Replace him, right? It's too much we got. Replace. And as long as we're inside our 45, we're good. Like if he still had the ball, this would be no good. Definitely no good, right? For example, we stacked if the quarterback still had the ball. But as long as we keep him in our 45 line, we're okay.